Hello friends, in this practical we will cover the second part of our practical number 2, that is the study of measuring instruments. Now in this practical we will cover the next measuring instrument, that is CRO. Now CRO stands for cathode ray oscilloscope. Now this is the front panel of your CRO and this is manufactured by Aplab company with the frequency of 20 megahertz dual trace oscilloscope. Now your CRO or your front panel of your CRO is basically divided into three sections. First one is your display, second one is your holds per division knob, and third one is your times per division knob. Now first of all let's see the display. Now your display is same as that of your graph paper. Now here this is the x-axis and this is y-axis. So total number of four quadrants, that is quadrant number 1, 2, 3 and 4. And here you will observe one square pattern is there. And one square equals to one division. Now by using this knob you can change the intensity of the waveform. Similarly by using this knob you can change the focus of the waveform. Then one important thing for your CRO is that there are total number of two channels are available on your CRO, that is channel number 1, or this channel is also called as an channel X, and second one is the channel number 2, and this channel is also called as an channel Y. Now by using this knob you can change or you can vary your waveform either upward or downward. See, I am varying the signal right now. Your waveform is varying either upward or downward. Then here the selection of the switch. Now right now your signal is applied to the channel 1, that's why I press this switch. Similarly if suppose your signal is applied to the channel 2, then you can press this switch. Now this is the important knob for your channel 1, that is holds per division. Now by using this knob you can change the amplitude of the waveform by keeping the frequency constant. Right now I am changing the holds per division knob. Now the amplitude is going to change but the frequency is constant. Similarly here which are the different signals or which are the different voltages you can calculate by using CRO. Now you can calculate AC voltage as well as DC voltage by using CRO. Now if suppose you are calculating AC voltage then press the switch. Similarly if you are calculating DC voltage then release the switch. Then the second button is for your ground. Now to make your waveform grounded you can press this switch. Similarly the working of your channel 2, that is by using this knob you can vary your waveform either upward or downward if suppose the signal is connected to the channel 2. Now if suppose here you will observe, that is there is no signal is applied to your channel 2. And similarly by using this knob you can change the amplitude of the waveform which is connected to the channel 1 by keeping the frequency constant by using this holds per division knob. Then which voltage you are calculating, either AC or DC and ground. And this knob is for the component testing. And the third section and the last section of the CRO, that is the times per division. Now by using this knob you can change or you can vary your waveform either right or left. Similarly this is the level fine knob. Now by using this knob you can make your waveform stationary. And this is the times per division knob. Means by using or by varying this knob, if you observe the waveform, then you will get idea. That is, by varying your times per division knob, only time or frequency is going to change, but amplitude is constant. Right now, the amplitude is constant, only time is changing. Now, our objective for this practical is to measure the AC as well as DC voltage and the frequency by using your CRO. Now, first of all, we will calculate the AC voltage and the frequency by using your CRO. Now to calculate AC voltage and the frequency by using CRO, we will require the another electronic instrument, that is the function generator. Now this is the front panel of your function generator. This is the display. On display you will get total number of three parameters. First one is your frequency, second one is your amplitude, and third one is your offset voltage. Now these are the various buttons which are available. Means first one is your functions. Now which are the different functions are available on your CRO? Now first of all you can calculate means which are the different functions are available on your function generator. That is the first one is your sinusoidal signal, then next one is your square wave or the triangular wave or noise signals are available on as a function on your function generator. Now the second knob is for your frequency, means when you press this switch, then you can change the frequency, then amplitude, similarly the offset voltage and remaining parameters. Now this is the keypad to change all these parameters, and by using these knob you can vary your parameter. And when you press the output, then you will get the same signal on your display. Right now, one signal is set by using your function generator, that is with the frequency of 1 kilohertz and the amplitude which is equals to 2 volt. Now if suppose you are going to change the amplitude, then please press the amplitude switch. Then you will get, if you observe, the amplitude button is blinking, and when you vary this knob, then you can change the amplitude. See, amplitude is going to change. Right now the amplitude is 2.4 volt peak to peak. Now let's fix our amplitude, which is equals to 2 volt. Right now the amplitude which is equals to 2 volt. Similarly, you can change the frequency also. Now when you click on frequency, then you will observe the frequency knob is continuously blinking, and by varying this knob you can change the frequency. Now if suppose one signal is generated from your function generator which is equals to 2 volt peak to peak and 1 kilohertz. Now this same signal we are going to calculate on your CRO. Now to calculate this function on your CRO, first of all connect your one probe to your CRO and another probe to your function generator, and connect positive to positive and negative to negative. Now when you will connect these connections, then you will get the sinusoidal signal. Now see, now I am going to change the function. Now the function is square wave, similarly the triangular wave, noise signal. Now the applied signal is the sinusoidal signal. Now the applied voltage which is equals to 2 volt peak to peak and frequency is the 1 kilohertz. Now how to calculate voltage by using CRO, that is important. Now to calculate voltage by using CRO, first of all measure how many vertical divisions are there. Now what is peak to peak voltage? Now what is peak to peak voltage? From positive peak to negative peak, this voltage is nothing but what? Peak to peak voltage. And what is peak voltage? From origin to either positive or negative, that is our peak voltage. Now here, by using your function generator, our applied voltage which is equals to 2 volt peak to peak, that's why your CRO will get the reading, that is voltage which is in peak to peak. Now first of all calculate how many divisions are there. Now vertical divisions are 2. That is, as I told you, that is 1 square equals to 1 division. Now to complete your waveform, you will require total number of 2 vertical divisions, means 1 division and another 1 division, means 1 plus 1, that is equals to 2 division. Now total number of 2 divisions, and second parameter is that position of your holes per division. Right now the position of your holes per division is at 1 hold per division. Now let just multiply total number of division into position of your holes per division. Right now the total number of divisions are 2 and the position of your holes per division is at 1 volt per division. So division will get cancelled. So 2 into 1 means calculated voltage on your CRO which is equals to 2 volt. Similarly, if suppose your amplitude which is equals to suppose 3 volt. Now the applied voltage which is equals to 3 volt peak to peak. Now calculate the output voltage. Now let's calculate total number of divisions, 1, 2, 3. So total number of divisions are 3, and the position of your holes per division which is equals to 1 volt per division, means 1 into 3, that is calculated voltage which is equals to 3 volt. Now this is how to calculate the voltage or AC voltage by using CRO. Similarly, we can calculate the frequency by using CR also. Now to calculate the frequency, now your applied frequency which is equals to 1 kilohertz. Now how to calculate frequency by using CRO, that is important. First of all, calculate the horizontal divisions to total number of horizontal divisions to complete one cycle. Now what is one cycle? One cycle is nothing but what? The positive half and negative half. Right now total number of horizontal divisions. Calculate total number of horizontal divisions required to complete one cycle. Now, if you see the, suppose, consider this is origin, then positive half and negative half means total number of one division is required to complete one cycle. Means one division. And to calculate the frequency, first of all, see the position of your times per division knob. Right now, the position of your times per division knob is at 1. Means 1 millisecond into 1 division means time is 1 millisecond. Now, as time is 1 millisecond, and we know the relation between your frequency and time, that is frequency and time are inversely proportional to each other. And according to CRO, we got the time which is equals to 1 millisecond. So, we can calculate the frequency, that is f equals to 1 upon d, that is f equals to 1 upon 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. Means calculated frequency on your CRO which is equals to 1 kilohertz. See, your applied frequency which is equals to 1 kilohertz and calculated frequency by using your CRO which is equals to 1 kilohertz. One more important point is that by using CRO, we can calculate the time, not frequency directly. First of all, calculate the time by using your CRO, then convert that time into the frequency by taking its reciprocal. Now, this is how to calculate your AC voltage and the frequency by using CRO. Similarly, we can calculate the DC voltage by using CRO. Now, how to calculate the DC voltage by using CRO? Now, let's check the connection. First of all, this is the CRO probe. Positive and negative. Now to calculate DC voltage on your CRO, you will require the DC power supply, and the working of your DC power supply we already covered in the practical, that is digital multimeter. As we know, for DC there is polarity, so connect your negative to negative and positive to positive. Now when you will connect positive terminal to positive and the negative terminal to negative and set the voltage, suppose your applied voltage which is equals to 3 volt. Right now the applied voltage which is equals to 3 volt. First of all, to calculate your DC voltage by using CRO, first of all make your waveform grounded. Right now your out voltage which is equals to 0 volt. And make sure that which voltage you are calculating. We are calculating DC voltage, so please release this switch. Now when you release the ground, then you will observe your waveform, it shifted upward by using or by some divisions. Right now your waveform is shifted by using how many divisions? 1, 2 and 3. Means total number of divisions are equals to 3. Means your waveform is shifted upward by 3 divisions. And let's take the position of your holes per division. Right now the position of your holes per division is at 1 hold per division. Now just multiply the total number of division into position of your holes per division. Now the total number of divisions are 3 and the position of your holes per division is 1 hold per division, means 3 division into 1 hold per division, division division will get cancelled. Finally, the calculated DC voltage on your CRO which is equals to 3 hold. This is how to calculate the DC voltage by using CRO. Thank you.